This is a community project, Alabama Boys State, sponsored by the American Legion. Comes every year, and we're meeting right now at the University of Alabama, and we've started doing community projects around the city of Tuscaloosa. The city of Tuscaloosa has been kind enough to get involved with this and put the money out there for it, and the Alabama Boys State is happy to help out. We've been working very hard. We got a lot of stuff accomplished. American Legion is happy to help out in any efforts that the city has, and it's just been a great endeavor all the way around.
Working with the people from the city of Tuscaloosa has been a great experience for me and all the other Boys Staters. It's given us a chance to give back to local communities and to give to the younger students. And everyone, I think everyone's really enjoyed it. I know I have.
What's going on in this week, for the 4 days of this week, is Boys State. It's a project that we are doing in conjunction with the city and the university and the Boys State division that comes here to the university for Boys State. And we're doing a community service project while they're here. And the benefits are that these schools, due to proration, doesn't have the funding to do the things around their buildings that helps children play and grow. And along with the children here are the people in this community that use these parks as their neighborhood parks. So from the Parks Division, it's a win-win for the community, for the kids at Boys State. It'll be something that they'll remember their whole life, that they help make a difference in this community. What they're doing this week is spreading fall material under the swing sets and playgrounds, picking up limbs around that we've cut, and painting curbing, things to make the schools more aesthetically pleasing and more user-friendly for the children as well as the members of the community.
The guys from Boys State are here at MLK Elementary School. They're doing a project for community service. It's a great school, so we're trying to help them out, repaint stuff, playground equipment, trying to redo some of the mulching around the playground for kids. Just about anything that we can come up with these guys to do, they do. No hesitation, these guys jump in head first, hands first. They're great kids. We don't take credit. These guys are awesome to come out here and do this stuff.
The kids would arrive in the afternoons. The city employees would be there with instruction, with having the equipment they needed and everything. And the kids jumped right in and went to work, and it was just seamless. It's a good thing to see. I think Tuscaloosa is to be commended for having a lot of dedicated folks that work hard for it.
From the city's perspective, this is a great opportunity, not only for us showing the boys that community service can go a long way, but for us to take advantage of to the labor that they are providing, to where we're not having to send city crews out and spend city dollars to do all of this work. The main focus of the project is to show the guys how a little bit of community service goes a long way in the lives of the children that go to these schools.
Well, I thought Boys State was a great opportunity. We had a lot of great speakers. We saw Coach Saban. We saw the mayor of Tuscaloosa.
Tuscaloosa County Park and Recreation is involved with the Young Men of the Boys State project this summer. We're excited to be involved more behind the scenes. We're helping provide the products that they need to do landscaping upgrades to the schools and the parks that they're working on this summer. The boys are able to come out and do some things for the schools, for the community. I mean, it's actually real work that we would have to pay for if they didn't come do it.
The time I've spent at Boys State has been great and extremely informative, and I've learned a lot about our government and about service.
Well, we're seeing the benefits this year of last year's Boys State participants. When you ride by any of the five parks that were rehabbed by those young men, you see kids playing, you see a lively park. It's beautiful to look at. And the same thing will happen when these kids return to school in August. What an incredible, incredible playground they now have at all four schools, where before it was dark and dirty. Now it's bright and brilliant with lots of seating, lots of color. All the swing sets have been painted, and it's just going to be so encouraging for the young people of those four schools.
I am real pleased with the improvements they have made here, because it gives a place for kids to come and play and for kids so they can come out here and improve in sports they wanted to succeed in. They have got new goals. They laid down some new boundaries on the courts, and they got some new nets. I think it's important because we can have more social events here and we can play regular basketball games.
It was really just a great experience for us to learn about how everyone else here dealt with their things in their community, and they were really warm to us and welcomed us because we were out here doing a service for them.
You know, these are top kids anyhow. but some of them don't have the opportunities, maybe where they come from, to get involved in community service. And they all seem really interested in helping other people. You know, you get the best kids from every community in Alabama, and you're not gonna have a bad week.
I believe the greatest thing in life is doing something that is greater than yourself. And what you did this week was make a difference in the lives of thousands of kids, most of them you will never meet. But you've put a mark on their lives that will carry something positive to them forever.
There's only two kind of people in this world, those that give and those that take, and you are truly givers. Thank you all for all you've done. Last year, you come to town and you turn our parks around. This year, you our playground. You took a slummy place and made it a sunny place, and we thank you.
We work in the community to help improve the quality of life. And I hope as you go back to your communities and you as future leaders, that's what you are, future leaders in your community, that you will understand the importance of parks and schools and recreation and police departments and fire departments. You know, it's all about a quality of life within your community, and it takes everyone working together to make that happen.
The answer to making a difference in your communities, in your state, is in your hands, and you've proved that this week by your commitment to being at Boise State and your commitment to improving this community.
Now we know that you understand that there is more than just doing the grades and attending school, that there is a civic responsibility, and you understand that.
It takes, obviously, a community to come together as one. Where there's unity, there's strength. That's quite obvious. And you have come into our community, come into our neighborhoods, and helped to strengthen us.
And I hope you now know that Tuscaloosa, which although may not be your home city, now always hopefully will have a place in your heart, because you have a place in ours.